So after spending tens of billions of dollars on the war in Ukraine, we now have a situation where a hurricane hit the southeastern United States of America, and you have people who are really struggling in North Carolina. And now FEMA, the Federal Emergency Management Administration or agency, came out and said that, hey, we don't know if we have enough money to make it through hurricane season.
Right after the devastation of Hurricane Helene. Listen.
We are meeting the immediate needs with the money that we have. We are expecting another hurricane hitting. We do not have the funds. FEMA does not have the funds to make it through the season.
This all comes as the Biden-Harris administration spent over $1 billion from a FEMA program on services for migrants.
How can you justify spending all that money on a foreign war and now you don't even have enough for the American people? And a lot of people are criticizing the government for spending a lot of money on migrants, illegal immigrants, and you have Americans. When Americans need the money, when Americans need support, it's like, oh, we don't have any money. But that's a part of what America has become. The government has become an America last mentality. That's what it is. It's about the foreign wars, the latest foreign war, Israel versus Iran. Iran fired over 200 or 300 or so missiles, ballistic missiles at Israel. There's a debate as to how much damage it actually did. Here's the bottom line. Israel is going to strike back. And when Israel strikes back, they're going to have a number of options. They can either target the regime, they can target a nuclear site, they can target the oil fields. Now, if they target the regime, they can have a situation where the current government could collapse and they can end up with an even worse government. They can have instability. Then they got to worry about what happens to those nuclear assets if you have a fight within that country over the government, over who takes power. You can have a situation where terrorist groups can get a hold of these nuclear assets if there are nuclear warheads. Something to think about. So Israel might just go after their nuclear, Iran's nuclear facilities. So to take away that threat, so it doesn't matter who's the government. They may decide to go after both. They may decide to go after Iran's oil assets. If they do that, Iran could retaliate by targeting American oil fields, American bases. If that happens, the U.S. government, U.S. military will be dragged into that conflict. And we're looking at a wider regional war. Meanwhile, we got people who are struggling here in America who don't have access to basic resources. We still have about 1 million or so people without power. Again, I'm not criticizing the government for that. I'm just saying that we shouldn't be running out of money to help Americans. I will say that. This is what we're getting from FEMA. This is what we're getting from Homeland Security. They could be running out of money. It's kind of disturbing, to say the least. It's very disturbing. Anyway, politically speaking, Harris... They are hustling. I will say this. The Democrats are hustling. Okay, Harris, they're sending out mail. I've received mail from her. I've received flyers. So they have people on the ground putting flyers in people's doors. So they got people doing the work. The Republicans aren't doing that. I'm just saying. I'm just pointing out the obvious thing here in Georgia. As far as politically speaking, one thing I got to say is about these black groups. I've been saying that, hey, black people are going to vote 90% for the Democratic Party no matter what. Now, if I'm wrong, I'll be the first person to admit it on election night. I am seeing that although young black women will continue to vote Democrat, and black people over the age of 50 or 60 will continue to vote Democrat, because when I look at traditional black organizations, they're just loaded with people over 60. You don't see a lot of young people in those organizations. Not that I'm an expert in that area. If I'm wrong, guys, correct me. But I'm just telling you what I see. I don't see a lot of people under 40 or under 50 at all. Don't see a lot of 20 and 30-something-year-olds. So there could be a divide with young black men going in a different direction politically. That could be real, and that could create a real problem for the Democrats. The thing is, when I look at these black organizations, I see organizations that represent the interests of the Democratic Party, not necessarily the interests of black people. When I see these Asian groups, they represent the best interests of the Asians, their actual constituents, people they work with, people they represent. When I look at Latino groups, they represent the best. They try to represent the best interests of Latinos. Well, let's see, these black groups, it's all about the Democratic Party. And so what the black population wants is pretty much ignored, politically speaking. I mean, that's just basically what I see. And it's sad, but I mean, that's just a reality. Nobody has any incentive to really pay attention to that. So what else is going on? The strike, the port strike, that is over with. The port workers, the longshoremen, have agreed to a deal in which their wages will increase 62% over the next 6 years. Now, they're still negotiating what they're going to do with automation. Now, the automation and robots, that's something I think the companies are going to try to push for. So they might give these guys their money right now, but long term, they can, we're going to replace them with robots and machines. I don't want to see human beings be replaced with robots and machines. This is just a reality I think is going on behind the scenes. So that situation has been resolved. Definitely concerned about the FEMA situation. Share your thoughts if you're knowledgeable about traditional black groups. Do you think there's going to be young black groups that actually break away from the traditional infrastructure of these black groups just representing the interests of the Democratic Party? Because they seem to be very much tied together. And I got to wonder, like, at what point does somebody say, okay, I'm not interested in the best interest of the Democratic Party. I'm interested in the best interest of the people I'm supposed to be representing. And again, you can see, you can say the same thing about the DC politicians, regardless of race. So anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for today. Oh, one more thing. Just because the strike is over with, that doesn't mean that you should ignore good reasons to prepare for emergencies. I know a bunch of people ran to the store and stocked up on stuff when bad weather was coming in, when there was a port strike. But it seems like when these crises go away, people just go like, oh, well, it's just become complacent again. I hope that doesn't happen again.